Coming up today on Better, have you caught the CBS show The Neighborhood?
It's great, and we're talking to two of its stars.
Plus, how does Happy Hour sound?
We've got a great new hilarious virtual show you can be a part of.
And not only are there drinks, it will also benefit a local theater.
And Chef Plum is teaching us how to make something that sounds complicated.
But he promises we can do it at home.
Your day is about to get better.
Starting right now. Hello. Hi, good afternoon.
Good afternoon. Welcome to Monday. You're almost done with your Monday. Thank you for being here for Better Connecticut. I'm Kara Sundland.
Get me a margarita, Kara.
It's National Margarita Day, Scott Haney.
Neither one of us are fans of margaritas. It's flavored and it's frozen.
I know people are yelling at their TVs right now.
Yeah, exactly. That's not the way to drink it. You drink it on the rocks.
The lime-flavored cocktail.
See, that's the way you drink it right there. Salted rim.
But sometimes they have, you know, nowadays it's kind of like martinis. You know, there was the martini, and now, you know, they have the Cosmo, and this margarita is the same way. You can have them pink, you can have them sugar on the edges.
I like them frozen and strawberried.
It's a tequila-infused beverage, of course.
Tequila-infused beverage. Well, who knew that there was a day specifically? They're not sure. They can't trace the lineage of this particular drink. They think it comes from Mexico, but they're not quite sure. I'm voting for Mexico.
Yeah, I always thought that it came from Mexico because it was a tequila, the little worm in the tequila comes from Tenochtitlan. I know, I remember learning this in a Spanish class. Anyway, enjoy a margarita if you are so want to celebrate today.
Yes.
It is official or becoming official. Kim Kardashian has filed for divorce to part ways with her husband, Kanye West.
It's so sad because mental illness is never a good thing. And we know Kanye has been diagnosed with bipolar disorder. And, you know, she did her best. She stuck with him through thick and thin. And
she's been very open about their struggles, and so has he.
Yep. Mm-hmm. So I just wish them the best.
Especially for their kids.
4 kids in 7 years. They had 4 children in 7 years of marriage. Isn't that pretty remarkable?
And so you got to hope that they can, you know, be friendly and be together for the kids.
And who knows? You never know what's going to happen in the future. But we wish them the best as they file for divorce.
So how about this? I think I would love to apply for this job.
Well, I'm going to.
Because it involves two things I love.
Yes.
Sleeping and luxury.
And money. 3 things.
Oh, yeah. But you get paid for doing things you love. Going to sleep in a 5-star resort. And it's a website, sleepstandards.com. They want a candidate to spend 5 nights in different environments. And then you'll write a little report.
What does that mean, different environments?
I guess they'll probably
like
have different
in the freezer,
beds.
In the cooler,
I'm sure they're going to want to show all this luxury sleeping they have. So maybe it's like one is a, you know, down comforter with a city-style window, and the other one is all.
And you have to review them as well.
Write a report on each night's luxury experience.
$2,000. For 5 nights, that's not bad, right?
All expenses paid, so the luxury vacation that you're going to take at this 5-star resort for 5 days is all paid for, plus you get paid to sleep and write about it.
Go to sleepstandards.com and scroll down to recent research and sleep tips and click dream job. We're going to pay you $2,000 to sleep in a 5-star resort.
Karen, you need to enter your headshot and a 60-second video about why you're the person.
It's like an actor's job here. This is unbelievable. Well, God bless. Good luck.
How about I'm really good at sleeping. I like luxury, and I write every day, so I know I can do this.
I'm the king of the naps.
I'm not a good napper.
I cannot nap.
My whole world is ruined if I take a nap.
Oh, that's terrible. I'm sorry to hear that.
No, I have to just start over. Like, then I have to wash my face again, eat again. Like, it's just, I can't really take a 20-minute nap.
Isn't that interesting? Very interesting.
All right. Six Flags is going to open, no matter what, all of its 26 amusement and water parks for the 2021 season.
Which I think is great.
Yeah, it gives something people to look forward to. I mean, I think we're used to this now. Every other venue is doing it socially distanced with reservations,
limited capacity. You gotta do the whole thing, but this opens up so many jobs for so many people.
Yes.
Just be careful.
And for those, you know, who it's outdoors.
Can you imagine they own 26 theme parks?
No, I didn't realize it was that many.
I didn't realize it was that many either. So many theme parks, so many people relying on this source of income. And so many people looking for something to do, Kara. They just want to get out of the house and do something.
A little roller coaster action.
We're not going on Superman.
Oh, I like the big roller coasters.
You like that, huh? Okay, well, I'll watch from the ground.
No. What if we just got you on it? It's 2 minutes of your life, and then you do a little review.
I don't know. It's just, I always think I'm going to get stuck up there, and I'll be up there for like 7 days.
So the Go-Go's are the subject of a new documentary, and it's chronicling the whole groundbreaking band's career. I've heard this is very good, and it releases, it's digitally available now, but they're also going to have it on DVD and Blu-ray coming out.
I think it should be called And We've Got the Beat.
Yeah.
Look at Belinda Carlisle. Would you look how young she is? Oh my God in heaven.
They're just having
oh
such
God.
A
head over heels, nowhere to go. Hands up myself, no dancing.
I'm like, look at the hair. I love it. All right, so they've been nominated to be in the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
Yeah, this is
a great year. They're having such another moment.
Good for them.
Where everything is new.
Who doesn't love the Go-Go's?
And Netflix, I think this is a great idea. Netflix now wants to animate the children's book written by the famous actress Lupita Nyong'o. She wrote a book, I believe it's pronounced Sulwe.
I think so. I think you're right.
It's Sulwe, but it was about a young, dark-skinned girl who goes on a magical journey to learn about self-esteem and true beauty.
Yeah, the book was a New York Times bestseller. No word on who's going to star in the film or when Netflix plans to release it.
Wouldn't it be great if she did? But probably would. It's going to be animated. I would think it would be animated.
Yeah, it looks absolutely great. Good. What a great production that's going to be. So I love it.
What a beautiful little book, too. That's a great thing to get.
Did you ever see the bull down by the Wall Street?
Yeah, I
didn't realize it was put there without any permission.
Oh, right. I didn't know that. That someone just stuck the bull there.
I was watching the CBS Morning Show, and I was like, somebody just dropped the bull there. The artist who did do this, he created the charging bull. He passed away at the age of 80.
Aww.
Arturo de Modica was 80 years old. He died on Friday in his hometown of Sicily, Italy. He dedicated the bronze statue without permission.
Just put it there in 1989.
He showed up with 40 of his friends.
And said, let's put this here.
Let's put this here.
It's so iconic.
Right?
You know, what a great story of someone who just believes in something and says, I'm going to do it.
I'm going to do it. I'm going to go in this.
It's easier to beg for permission, beg for forgiveness and ask for permission.
Stealth of darkness. And he drops this big bull.
It's like the
on Wall Street.
It's like the obelisks that we're showing. All right. So a Tennessee family is having a lot of fun with their pet chicken. Have you been thinking about maybe getting a chicken? They're hot pets right now for the pandemic. Yeah.
People. Chicken?
Yes. All over Connecticut, people are using the services where they bring the chickens and the coops.
Well, this chicken likes to slay.
Yeah, this one.
Apparently, he was in a raft in the middle of the summer. That was when he was a baby. And now he loves to slay. He goes down the hill in Tennessee, and there is the chicken, leaving no foot unturned. Look at him.
He's absolutely not chicken at all.
He looks, is it a rooster or a chicken?
I mean, he kind of looks like a rooster, but they say he's a chicken, so I'm going to believe him.
All right, he's 11 years old.
How long do chickens live?
Depends on, the quality of life that they get.
This one's got a good quality of life. He's just a pet, and he gets to hang out with the kiddos.
It's great... He doesn't know he's going down a sled. He's a chicken with a brain the size of a thumb.
I don't know. God, it looks pretty smart to me. Made himself very valuable to that family.
He certainly did.
And how about this? A little koala has received the world's first prosthetic foot. Especially designed for our marsupial.
His name is Triumph, Kara.
Oh, of course it is. Look at
him. He was born without a right foot. He was rescued in 2017 right next to his dying mother.
Oh.
This Marley Christian found him.
And a nurse there.
And she's probably going to be with him the rest of his life because he's got to be held in captivity.
But look, so that's his little
prosthetic.
Using it.
Oh, my God, it's so adorable. He said, it feels comfortable? Well, apparently they think it feels comfortable.
And they, this was a no small feat. They tried several times and failed.
I get it, no small feat.
You know, actually, I didn't intend, but you're right. But they tried a bunch of times, and it wasn't working. So this was about just staying really true to this baby koala, who's not a baby anymore, and helping him get a foot that works.
Carrie, you got to get one of those.
I really want a koala. Sorry. I'm sure it's not allowed.
I'm sure if anybody has a koala out there, and they'll let Carrie know.
Anyone has a koala living in Connecticut, please email me, kara.sunlin@wfsb.com. I will come interview you.
I love this. All right, when the Butler County, Ohio Sheriff's Office got the call, they were ready to report a suspicious package looking for TikTok and the whole nine yards. Turns out all that was coming from the bag was a bunch of meows, Kara.
Little mom and her baby kittens.
Well, you know what? Thank God, though, they dropped them off at a place of decency instead of trying to get rid of them.
Yeah.
You know, I kind of think they did the right thing. They couldn't take care of the animals.
So they put them,
outside and, you know,
look at
the little babies. They're on their way to foster care. which is good. Look at how tiny they are, right, Kat?
Oh, I love them when they're that little.
Little tiny little fur creatures. God bless.
Mom's name is Sprinkles. Oh, so they put the notes on everything. Okay, that's really nice.
That's really nice.
And just nice that it's something to think about, that there's always that safe harbor that you can help the animals.
Exactly.
And human babies as well.
Absolutely, human as well.
All right, for all the latest celebrity news and much more, you can always tune into People TV. It's right here on Channel 3 at 7:30.
We're going to Jeremy today for a preview. Hey, Jeremy, how are you?
Tonight on People, Bling Empire is the real-life version of Crazy Rich Asians. The first season on Netflix is definitely a binge-worthy hit. It's focusing on the lives of wealthy Asian and Asian American socialites based in the Los Angeles area.
Were you apprehensive at all in showing this side, specifically of Asian culture?
Yeah, you know, it's been definitely a journey, just because like the Asian culture tend to be a little bit more low-key and stay like, you know, don't air all your dirty laundries, let's stay private.
Kelly Mee Lee came up with the idea of the show after reading the popular book and comparing some of the characters to her actual friends.
King's family is one of the largest like oil and shipping companies in Asia. Christine Chu and her husband Gabe actually came from the Song Dynasty era. Kim, obviously, she's a self-made DJ. Kevin's, in our group circle, and Kevin's just still trying to make it.
With the help of Jeff Jenkins, the producer of Keeping Up with the Kardashians, she created the show and set out to try and break Asian stereotypes.
What specifically were those that you were anxious to break?
The answer to that tonight on People.
Looks fascinating.
Yeah.
Awesome.